Now in this problem, using superposition theorem, find the current in 23 ohm resistor in the circuit shown in the figure. So you have to use a superposition theorem and you have to find how much current is passing from 23 ohm resistor. So for the solution of this problem, so in this problem there are two sources. The one is the voltage source here and the another is the current source 20 ampere. So there are two sources in this circuit. So there are two steps, the step A and B, or you say the step 1 and 2. How many number of sources are there, that number of steps will be there. So in the step A we have to keep one source and the other we have to delete. So in the step A, I am keeping the voltage source that is 200 volt. I am not deleting this, I am keeping, and I am eliminating. So I am not keeping the 20 ampere current source. So what I have to do, I have to open, because the another source is the current source. So I have to open the 20 ampere source. This source I have to open and make the circuit again. So we have to open the current source 20 ampere. So it means this you have to remove from here. This is not the part of the circuit. Now what we have to do, now in the remaining circuit we have to find the total. This is in the step A. The first point is the remove. The first point is remove the current source. If the voltage source is there, so we have to short the voltage source. So here remove current source. So this already we have removed. And in the second point, in the remaining circuit, we have to find the total resistance of this circuit. Now to find the total resistance of this circuit, now you see this, the resistor 4 ohm. The resistor 4 ohm and the resistor 23 ohm, they are in series. So this 4 ohm plus 23, so this is 27. And this together, this 27 together and this 27, so they are parallel. So this 27, this 27 ohm is parallel with 27 ohm, this one. So this will be equal to, this is 1 over 27 plus this is 1 over 27, so this is equal to 13.5 ohm. It will come like this. And after that, this 13.5 and this 47, they are in series. So this 13.5 and plus this is 47, so this is equal to 60.5 ohm. So this is the total resistance value of the circuit. So the RT of this circuit is coming here, it is 60.5 ohm. Now in the third step of the step A is you have to find the total current in this circuit. So this total current is the voltage over RT, and the voltage is 200, and the total resistance is coming 60.5. so this is equal to 3.3 ampere, and this is the value of the IT. Okay, from the last slide, we got the value of the total current. That is, this is IT, and the total current is coming 3.3 ampere. Now, this total current is coming from here or coming here. So this current is, this is the IT current. This is IT current and it is 3.3 ampere. Now, when this current is coming at this node here, so this current is, some current is coming here, and you say coming here in the branch, this current is coming here. This current is passing here like this. So this, some current is passing from 4 ohm and this is 23 ohm, 4 ohm and 23 in series. So you say this is I1 current which is passing through 4 ohm and this is 23 ohm together like this, and some current is coming from here. Now we have to find the current passing through 23 ohm. Basically here we have to use the CDR, rule to find the current through 23 ohm. So basically we have to take the, here for this, the formula is, that is R total of the parallel circuit. This is R total of the parallel circuit, and here it will come R 23 ohm, and this is multiplied by IT. So this is IT. So here this R total, first we have to find, and this R total is, the sum of this, the parallel, and the sum of this one. So the R total here, this is 1 over 27, and here this is 1 over 27, because 27, because this is 4 here and this is 23 here, so they are in series. So we have to take the resistance from this point to this point. That's why we added here. Now the total resistance, this, if I solve this, so it will come 13.5 ohm. So this is coming 13.5 ohm. Now here we will not take, this 23. This 23 is wrong. We have to take, the question says what is the current passing through 23 ohm. But with this 23 ohm, the one another resistance is connected in the series. So if you see this, so if I say how much current is passing from here like this. So this 23 ohm, this 4 ohm and this 23, they are in series. So the same current is passing from here and the same current is passing from here. So we will not take this 23. We will take this 23 plus 4 and this is equal to 27 ohm. So this is the resistance. So this is the resistance of the branch. We have to take the resistance of the branch. So this will not come here like this. So it will come, 27 here, not 23. So it will be 27, and this is multiplied by, what is the total current here? Total current is 3.3, and if I calculate this, so this is the 1.65 ampere, and the direction of the current is down. So this is going downside. Direction is also very important in the superposition rule. So here this is the direction in the step A. The direction of the current in 23 is, this is 1.665 ampere, and this direction is downside, down. Now we will move to the now this is for the step B. So in the step B, what we have to do, we have to keep, we are keeping this 20 ampere source. We are keeping this and we are shorting this 200 voltage source. So this is shorted in the step B. This is shorted here. So now ultimately we have to find the value of this I2. So what is the value of the I2 in the step B? The value of the I2 in the step B. So now see in this circuit how the resistors are connected. Now this and this, okay, if I see this 47 and 1 and this is 27, they are in parallel. So this is 1 over 27 plus this is 1 over 47. If I calculate this part, so this will be 17.1 ohm. So this is 17.1 ohm, and to this is in series. So this 17.1 and plus 4, so this is 21.1. so from here to here, it is, see, this is like this. Here this is one current source and this current source is 20 ampere. And here the resistance is coming. This is coming 21.1 ohm. And here this is another resistor and this is 23 ohm. And we have to find how much current is passing from here. So for this we can use the CDR, because when the current is coming here, some current will pass from here, some current will pass from here. So in this, to find the value of the current from 23 ohm resistor, we can use the CDR rule. So for the CDR rule, the current passing from 23, so this is the total of the parallel circuit. What is the total here? The total of this is the 1 over 20.1 and plus this is 1 over 23. So this total we have to take, and if I solve this, so this will come, this is 11 ohm. So in the formula of the CDR, so this is RT and this is resistor 23 ohm and multiply by the total current. So here that this is 11 and here this is 23 multiply by 20. So if I solve this, it will come 9.5 ampere. And see the direction of this. See the direction. This direction is downside. This direction is down. Now see from the step A. So from the step A, the direction of, if you see from the step A, the direction of, this is here in the step B, the I2 is coming, this is coming 9.5 ampere. So this is coming 9.5 ampere in the step B. But from the step A, the I1, the value of the I1, it is, so if it is, if I see from the set A, the I1 is coming, this is coming 1.65 ampere. So now what you have to do, you have to find the total current from the step A and the step B. Now if I see from the step A and from the step B, so from step A and from the step B, so the direction of the I1, this is the direction of the I1 and this is the direction of the I2. So both are going in the same direction. So ultimately the current passing through 20 ohm resistor is equal to, this is I1 plus this is I2. So now if you take the sum of this, so this is 9.5 plus it is 1.65, and this is equal to, so now the sum of this, it will come, this is 11.15 ampere current which is passing through 23 ohm resistor. So in the superposition theorem, you have to find the current in a particular resistor from the set A and from the set B, and you have to find the direction. If they have the same direction, then it will come plus. If they are in the opposite direction, so it is minus. So the final answer from 23 ohm resistor is 11.15 ampere. So thanks for the watching.